Expect all action this one. Will be entertaining. Yep, well left. So they're a pretty good nick in that sense. They've won the last three. Just correct myself there in the fact, actually. Last time they failed to get 68, sacked 31 and lost 37, so they've lost more than they've won. The Canada Open in the last tournament they played, they were out in the second round. Through Yang Po Han, last seven tournaments, only twice. They are leading here against the number. Thirteen times they've met Chinese Taipei opponents in this round. They've won 12. Li Fengqi and Li Feng. Unsurprising, perhaps, the Chinese Taipei pair have met. They won that in the last round of this tournament. Lovely. Excellent. They've just stepped it up since the break. Just I remember at the interval it was 11-8. A lot more match it. The overall win rate's just over 70%, so this has been good. No, it's Indonesians wrong a few times in momentum. Pair who've won 150 in 2023. So to match start stage, a bit of a comeback there, the Chinese Taipei pair. Oh, good evasive manoeuvres there.
Yeah,
easy one again. This back in 2019, and they got to the final last year. Oh, great. Easy. Oh, they've kept it alive, but not for two. It's been a pretty good time for Alfian and Arianto. Well, number one pairing, as you said. Malaysia also blessed with many men's doubles partnerships. Thailand Open, they got to the quarterfinals, also thanks to home one. Runners-up finish at the Malaysia Open, semi-finals of the India Open, quarters of the Indonesia Masters. They've now won in both. Quarter-final. Still have 5 match points.